things are really starting to heat up on The Bachelor. Last night, another lady left the mansion and only five remain. To talk about what went down, we are joined by the entertainment editor of news.com, and she's a bit of a Bachelor tragic as well, Alison Stephenson. As well, we're joined by Bachelorette Laurina, who left the competition last night.
Laurina.
Alison, we might start with you. What did you make of last night's episode?
Oh, goodness. Look, to be honest, I'm still recovering from last night's episode. It was an absolute cracker. Now, there were a few little uncomfortable moments, none more so than from Laurina, who I'm sure we'll hear from later. But look, you know, it started off with Sam. She was taken to a jewellery store and she sort of was in tears at the prospect of borrowing some jewellery. We then went on a group date and we all love the group dates.
Yes.
But Jess got a little bit gushy. Now, typical Jess, she ended up telling Blake that seeing him was like watching the sunrise. With that, I know. It's possibly one of her best lines we've heard so far.
She's stealing lines from Kutut.
Well, yes, that is exactly what she is. Yeah. She could be the new Rhonda, let's just say that.
That doesn't work on guys.
In case anyone
else is thinking that, we do not want to look like sunrises.
It does work on Blake, though. He was lapping it up. He was loving it. Wow. But look, the show sort of ended with a couple of awkward moments with Laurina. And to be honest, I think there's a lot of really disappointed people that she's not on the show anymore because she really has a huge fan following.
Oh, yeah. Laurina, I'm a huge fan of yours and a lot of my girlfriends absolutely adore you, and especially some of the particular things you've been saying about a dirty pie and all those
dirty
sorts of
things. Dirty street pie.
Mm. How are you feeling now that you're out of the house?
Oh, it's such a relief. I mean, it was an incredible experience, but it's been a massive roller coaster as well.
But did you think you might hook The Bachelor?
Look, after I came out of hospital, it was really hard for me to get back into it. I'd had a dose of reality. So when I came back into the house, I sort of couldn't, you know, really get back into it. So I was like, how many girlfriends?
we might take a look at the moment that the romance ended for you last night, Laurina. I hope it's not too raw. But just to bring everyone up to speed, here's how it went down.
There's a lot of things that I want in a partner that I see in you, and I see a lot of potential for us. And what I want more now is more intimacy. I want to be able to... Okay.
Continue.
No, I'm sorry.
Laurina, do you think maybe it was too much too soon? Guys don't like the talk.
Oh, look, it was actually, that was the moment where we had to put it all out on the table.
Sure.
We weren't going to get many opportunities with Blake. And I said to him, I feel like we've established a connection, but I don't know how to move forward from here. And I said, you know, for me to be able to move forward, I would need more intimacy. And that was the moment that it was like, I felt like I was boring him at that.
Because, Laurina, I thought you were very good, especially early on, at playing hard to get. You really sort of had that technique, it seemed, down pat.
Look, I wasn't really playing hard to get. There was a bit of an editing discrepancy there. I actually said that first night, I really don't feel well, so I don't want to talk to him while I don't feel well, so I'm happy to be a bit mysterious tonight. So it didn't show me saying I don't feel well, but I did tell Blake that as well when he came and sat down. I said, I'm sorry, I wanted to dazzle you this evening, but I really don't feel well. So I was actually quite polite and courteous to him. I didn't walk off on him
I think you knew, didn't you? When you said you were looking for more intimacy, he didn't really react. So I suggest that perhaps you just weren't the one for him.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was getting to the point where the connection had really dissipated, dissolved, and it was just getting awkward. And I felt like when I was removed from the situation last night, it felt perfect. The timing felt really, really right.
Have you asked him for a reference for the next bloke you
meet? No. To be honest, I don't think he knows me well enough to be able to give me a legit one.
You don't need one. You're perfect.
Yeah, it's a jungle out there. Hey, let's have a look at the moment that Blake did make his decision.
Lisa.
Wow.
Lisa,
some
what are you
very dramatic movements there. Ali, what do you make of that?
look, you can cut the air with a knife, can't you? I mean, look, you'd have to be a brave woman to be standing in that room when that went down.
It's always the smile too. You can tell when a girl smiles a little bit. You know, someone's in a lot of trouble.
Absolutely. There's a lot going on behind the scenes there, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Laurina, what I always find is very useful, and I think you were kind of edging towards it but didn't quite get there, you've got to go the preemptive breakup. You've got to sniff when someone's about to break up with you and you go, before you go on, you're dumped.
Yeah, I know. Otherwise, it creates this awful sense of urgency where you're like running on a mouse wheel trying to redeem things, and it was just, there was no connection there in the end, and like the home visits were coming up as well, so to get out of there when I did was perfect timing.
We really hope you do find love. To put yourself out there like you have takes a lot of bravery, and obviously it's something you desperately want. Go and have a dirty street pie. It always makes me feel better. Thank you so much for coming on the show. You're a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
You will find love. Ali, thanks as well.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, another Bachelorette will leave the competition tonight, and we'll be chatting with her tomorrow.